For the filtration experiment, we will use our raw water as a model water. We prepare it by adding clay and iron suspension over tap water, and we mix it up using a stirrer. And then this is in order to simulate a type of water that is highly turbid, which is quite common in surface water. However, in practice, if you want to do this pilot experiment to design a plant, you will need to perform this experiment not using model water, but using the actual water that you're planning to treat. The raw water, we put it in this tank, and then from this tank, we pump the water using a peristaltic pump up to the top of the column. From the top of the column, then water starts to build up. Here you have a layer of water on top of our sand filter. By gravity, the water flows through the sand filter down to the gravel subbase, and from here we have the tubes coming out from here as our effluent water. So this is our treated water coming out here. Now we can also, adjust the flow rate of our filter column by adjusting the flow meter that is installed at the effluent side of our setup. Now we can also monitor two parameters we need to design for our rapid sand filter. So here we installed at different levels of the column some piezometers. So here, the first one, second, third, and the fourth one right in the effluent side of the column. At the same time, we can also take water samples to monitor the water quality of the water. Here, there's a tab where you can collect samples. First one, second one, third one, and fourth one. So once we collect the sample from this tab, we then measure turbidity using a turbidity meter, and then using the two data from the head loss development and the turbidity measurements, you have to do further analysis. Shortly, you will see a demonstration of how these experiments will perform in pilot scale. For our backwashing experiment using our pilot scale rapid sand filter, it is important to obtain information on the physical properties of the sand filter and also the optimum backwash rates for an effective cleaning of the filter media and also the amount of backwash water required for the cleaning. Well, in this experiment, we will use the same 10 centimeter diameter column. We fill it up with the same sand material, sand media that we use for our filtration experiment. Here we backwash the system with tap water. We store it in this plastic container. In reality, we backwash the system normally with the effluent of the filtration setup. So you collect the filtrate during filtration, and part of it you use it to clean the system through backwashing. To backwash, first you pump the water from your backwash water tank using a pump here. It has a float controller. So when you turn on the pump, the water flows from the bottom through the sand filter. So when you backwash the system, depending on the flow rate, your sand filter will expand, and it will expand much further with higher flow rate, and with lower flow rate also has a lower expansion depth. And the water flow to the top of the water column, and then goes to the outlet and go to waste. Our experiment for backwashing will be performed by varying the backwash flow rate and also the water temperature by changing the conditions here in our water tank. And we can also change the backwash flow rate by changing the flow rate from the effluent tubes. The head loss also will have to be monitored. So we have 2 points that we have to monitor in terms of the piezometric pressure. So here we inserted the piezometer at the top layer of the column, which is still in the water column level. And also we have a piezometer here right in the effluent side of the column. And then the difference between the two is our head loss. Depending on the flow rate of our backwashing, then our head loss will also increase. Shortly, you will see a demonstration of how our experiments during backwashing will be done in pilot scale.